adventure, sports, outdoors. With host Harry Canterbury.
There I was, back in the wild again. And I fell right at home, where I belong. I had that feeling coming over me again, just like it happened so many times before.
Hi, Harry Canterbury with another edition of Adventure Sports Outdoors. Join us today, spring fishing in Victoria, Illinois, with Pat Sullivan and Mike O'Brien in the strip mines. We had some fantastic crappie fishing. It's been really warm this early spring. In fact, they're getting mushrooms in the middle of March. So who knows what's going to come up next. The turkeys are laying eggs, they're gobbling, and the fish are biting. But we also have a segment of coyote hunting near Morton, Illinois. And we've got my friends with me here today, Art Wiegand, and we've got Phil Wetstein, and Art Hunsicker, who are going to narrate a little bit about this coyote hunt that was held at the end of January. So stay tuned today for a great show.
Adventure Sports Outdoors, brought to you in part by Corsaw Lumber, manufacturers of quality hardwood products and buyers of standing timber in Smithfield.
Rawlings Trailer Sales, supplying sportsmen with all their trailer needs just south of Hopedale.
REMAX, specializing in commercial and recreational property in Peoria. Michael O'Brien, president.
Kaler's Irish Pub and Eatery, located on Peoria's riverfront, open 11 a.m. daily.
Alwyn & Sons Meat Company since 1957, located in Peoria Heights, Illinois.
Our thanks to these sponsors.
See who this guy is here? This is Michael O'Brien. We're out at Irish Acres out near Victoria, Illinois. And we're going to catch some fish today. This is a super time to fish. It's crappie season, and they're biting right now. We were playing around on the dock over there, and Pat Sullivan and I caught about 10. And they got bigger. They started here, and they got that big, and now they're that big. We're going to catch some 10 to 12, 14-inch crappies. Is that right?
You bet. You bet. We've transitioned between three stages over the last 2 weeks with our weather changes, and today should be the best day we'll have all spring.
It's going to be 75 degrees today?
You bet.
75 degrees on the 13th of March, and global warming is here. We're thinking about planting palm trees up here on Mike's place. Found a couple good spots to put them
there. Yeah, a couple margaritas, you know, and we'll have it made.
Be like Jimmy Buffett land.
You bet.
But anyway, stay tuned for a great show today. We're going to catch a lot of crappies.
We traveled all over to fish for some real exotic fish like grayling in Alaska, northers in Ontario, yellowfin tuna in Honduras, and snook in Florida. But this month, we decided to stay home and fish for those delicacies of the Midwest fish world, crappie, bluegills, and bass. And boy, did we get into some real great fishing.
Use these super small jigs today because it's just so clear and the water's so cold, and it's just going to be a finesse type fish today. Watch, we'll come back up here. There's something, or a bluegill. But if you bring it back quietly, and you can see 5, 6, 7 bluegills following these things back. Now that's not what we're here for today. We're going to catch some big crappies, but it's nice to know that the fish are becoming more active.
Show everybody what we're using there, Mike.
We're going to use a super small Berkeley-style gulp minnow on a, I don't know, this is probably a 16th-ounce jig with an extra wide gap hook for the crappies. And those crappies will, you know, it'll be a lot easier to hook these crappies on a bigger hook. And we're probably going to use bobbers if these fish aren't going to be active enough to chase the jig as you're reeling it back. We'll put a bobber about 5-6 feet above, bring it back, let it sit, and those crappies will come up and munch it.
Well, I hope so.
There we go. I got one. That was right next to the boat. Oh, it's another big bluegill.
It is.
I thought it was a crappie. Look at
these. Let's take a look at that. That's a nice bluegill.
Again, bigger than the hand. I mean, they're big fish.
I'm talking you into saving them. You were throwing them all back earlier.
Well, I was throwing them back because I don't want to share my good bluegills with you, Harry.
I know.
So, okay, we'll put
yeah, start saving those in there. Let's eat those. I like those bluegills just as well as I do the crappies.
Well, I do too.
They're delicious.
How far do you got that on, Mike?
I'm fishing about 5 feet deep. And again, we'll show you the rig set up. We're fishing a bobber 4-pound test. And then we've got a super small Berkeley gulp minnow on a 32nd-ounce lead head.
Crappie. I'm using a little crappie jig here, little pink crappie jig. Pink was working earlier for us.
Oh, yeah, we're tearing them up.
Yeah. So we'll try that. If it doesn't work, I'll go with what the guy's hitting, the hot hand.
The hot hand.
On my super long crappie pole.
There's a fish. Now what we're doing is we're just coasting this bobber with this jig over the top. Oh, I missed him.
you missed him? Did you really?
I had him. And look what he did to my tail.
Oh, he broke your tail.
Yeah, broke my tail off. We're just using these little Berkeley gulps. A lot of times we'll take some super glue and put some super glue on there to keep them
on there.
Yeah, to keep them on there. And I've got some super glue in here. If we keep going through these like we're going through them right now with all the bites, then we're going to have to start big glue.
Back to back in about 2 minutes.
You got a smaller bobber there? I got too heavy a bobber.
How much money you got, Pat?
I got little.
Andy Lane, he had that. I couldn't have lost that fish if I'd have tried.
Hold it right there. Let's take a look. That's a nice one. Nice.
Again,
boy, they're good.
They're
now.
They're bigger in my hand. So.
They're like little ice cubes, aren't they?
Yep. They're
cold.
They're very cold.
Very cold.
Good.
Boy, I tell you, this is going to be really tasty because this cold meat's going to be just firm. I happen to have some of my world famous breading. And a nice clean fryer up in the shed, and we're gonna cook some fish when we get done catching some of these crappies. We might have to make this a early bluegill, ice out bluegill show.
Yeah, wow.
I might have to get a smaller bobber.
Certainly wasn't much ice out here.
No, we never drilled a hole this year.
Never got thick enough, did it?
There was one lake down off of the road down here that ice freezes up. He had 4.5 inches of ice. He went 3 days, and that's all he got out of it.
Yep, and a couple guys made it at Oak Run, too, for a couple days, and that was it.
That was about it.
Yep.
Okay, I need a smaller bobber.
Don't stay. No.
There's one. There's a nice one off the back of the boat.
Did you pull it right off the back? Are you just trolling?
Yeah, I was just trolling a little bit.
You get a crappie?
Nice little fight. No, nice bluegill.
A good bluegill.
Another bluegill.
Boy, a lot of bluegill.
Look at the size of that one. Woo-wee.
Let's take a look at it.
Look at it. He ate a minnow. Look
That's
at that.
A nice bluegill.
Got a knucklehead. Yeah. There, took that
minnow.
Oh,
I love
right
to eat those things. Gosh.
But with these lightweight poles, they feel like a big bass on there. Look at that. Look at the yellow bellies on them.
Oh, yeah.
They
nice,
are.
Nice, healthy fish.
Healthy fish. They'll fry up good.
Now, you know, Mike, a lot of people got bluegills, but what's your secret to keeping these things big?
Well, I think you have to manage it.
You're feeding them?
Well, the only thing we feed are the catfish here. And when they're kind of our pets, we keep those for predators. And what we do is, the rule is you can keep all bluegills, all crappies, and all bass under 9 inches and take them home and clean them. Obviously, if you catch a 2-pound crappie, take a picture and let it go.
Right.
There's plenty of good eating here for fish.
Yeah.
And what that does is that it culls the little fish out of here.
What's neat is, what a way to come and clear your mind, get things off your mind, and get out in the open. And
hey, come up here and not worry about politics, can't you, Pat?
Yeah.
There's another pair over there. I think they're... I think they already got a nest.
I have two nests over here. I have one in the wetlands and one about halfway up in an old beaver hut area on the other side of the lake. And matter of fact, I'm going to probably have to get out there and clean out the nest and put straw in it because at home we have an island on our pond and those geese are already claiming the island, pushing every other bird that lands on the lake off the lake.
There they go.
There they go. They come right over us down there. Nope, the wind's down.
We have a wetlands up on top of that hill. So they're getting pretty territorial already. And I think we're going to have an early spawn on the fish. We're going to have an early hatch on the geese.
Might even have early mushrooms.
Well, that'd be nice too, wouldn't it? last year we didn't have much of a mushroom patch. At least I didn't.
No, that was mushrooms were short all over.
Yeah.
You got one on, Pat?
Yep, I got one on. Whoop, he's got Mike's line.
You guys are tied up, huh?
I need a help from Mike.
No, go ahead.
Oh, nice bass.
Nice bass. Yeah.
Got a bass.
Got a little bass here.
Want to eat?
Yeah, off a little ultralight. That's fun. Look at that. I told you I was going to catch a bass today.
Yeah, you were.
Right, now, that's the size. I got a crappie here.
That's the size you like to eat, right?
Anything under 12 inches. I got a crappie. There's a crappie.
I think he's a little big, isn't he, Mike?
Yeah, let him go.
Yeah, he's a little big.
So this is not a very big crappie, but look how thick.
That's a 3/4 pound, isn't it?
Yeah, but look how thick they are. They're real thick.
They're good,
they're
healthy
real
fish.
Stout,
yeah.
Real
that's
stout.
Nice fish.
And he had that pretty good.
Let's take a look at it.
There you go.
Yeah, that's a good fish.
All right, we're going to catch another one here in just a second.
Another one? Oh, I love that sound.
I got one too.
Double.
Double. We got two of them. Now you keep yours on the left so we don't get them stuck together. Come on.
I don't have him trained.
Come on.
I don't have him trained.
Did you not reel in a crappie?
No. Nice and easy.
Okay, they call you're fighting that one. I'm just going to show you how they're supposed to be.
Well, look at how big one. Mine is, though.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a good one. Yep.
Big one there. Look at it. You better get Pats, too. Pats is a pig, too.
Oh, nice.
There you go. That's a double, man. Good job, buddy.
Well, that's a nice fish. Good.
Yeah, these are nice. Now, these are almost a foot long, but look how thick their bellies are. The belly's already got eggs in it.
Crappie,
it's a big female. And she's pretty darn close.
Let me have that one, Mike.
There you go, Pat.
I'll put it in the thing, but do you want to get a picture of that?
Get a picture of that.
Okay, let's look at a picture.
He needs a front cover.
While you're taking a picture.
Catch another one.
I'll catch another one.
Okay.
Another one.
Another fish. What we catch like?
Crappie. Well, you could see these about six, 8 feet
down.
Yeah. Look at that.
Yeah, this
one a minute.
Look at that.
Nice, big, fat one, too. Another nice, fat one.
Mm. Better get us out of here so we don't spook these fish.
Yeah, another nice fish.
These are big crappies.
That's a good
fish.
Yeah, that'd be a good eater.
Yep, that's a good one, Pat.
Flay him up and put him in the grease. Release to the grease, Harry.
Fish on. Fish on. There's another crappie.
Another crappie.
Not as big. He's only about 8 inches. That's a big one.
That's a good one.
There's a good one.
Good one. Good fish.
This was Harry's, actually.
That's a nice fish.
He got on the camera again. I'm trying to grab the camera from him.
Well, that's a good fish. We want to catch fish.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Action. There we go. Hey, you got a nice one there.
Yeah, that's probably the big one of the day right here.
Oh, that's a nice, nice fish. Nice fish.
Nice.
What do you think that's going to weigh? That's almost, a pound and a quarter?
Oh, Harry, I wish it was, but I think it's just under a foot long.
Yeah, that's a nice
darn
fish.
Darn close. Look how fat she is. That's full of eggs.
Nice, nice.
Already, and it's not even St. Paddy's Day.
Yeah, that's a nice fish.
Pat, I'm going to give you honors because we're going to eat.
Another good one.
Got another nice one.
Right off of shore, taking a break.
Right there, nice fish.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Yeah, that's a nice crappie.
That's one of the better crappies today.
Fat.
Look at how good that thing is.
Not as long, but it's fat.
Swallowed it.
Whoops.
Can't see.
Swallowed it here.
That's what it's all about right there.
Yeah,
there
isn't that great?
Barry, yours was bigger than mine.
Was it really?
Yeah, it was. Oh, I missed it.
Yeah.
Again.
Holy shit, look at the fish. We have to step back so we don't turn the damn boat over.
That's a nice mess of fish, guys.
I'm Dave Barth with your shooting tip of the week. A good alternative to this year's slug season is muzzleloaders. A couple of examples here. This is a Thompson Center Encore Endeavor. It's a single shot muzzleloader. You fire black powder pellets. You can use between 100 and 150 grains of pellets. Use a Savater bullet and shotgun primers. The advantage of the shotgun primers is that they're waterproof and you get surefire ignition every time. If you want to go a primitive rifle, this is a Thompson Center Hawken. It's a flintlock. Here are some of the accessories you would need to shoot that. You need patches, round balls, flask, you need loose powder, a cleaning solvent. You can shoot maxi balls, and then the grease that you need for the balls. I'm Dave Barth with your shooting tip of the week.
Beautiful day, ready for the coyote drive. And just in case we don't see one, got one right there. 2 inches of fresh powder. It doesn't look good for the coyotes today. We've got 3 sections to drive, and it looks like it's going to be a bad day for the coyotes. Anything can happen at any time at this point. Okay, we got one still in. Boys. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Look at what we got.
Oh, my.
Oh, male.
Oh, male.
We have a small highlight film that our friend Sandy Whisker made for us from a coyote hunt in January of this year. She took all the photos and put them together with some music. Pretty interesting mix, along with some great get-up-and-go music. Hope you enjoy it. What's their main source of food?
I feel like it's a lot of deer.
A lot of young deer, crippled deer.
Yep, they eat a lot of wounded deer and field dressed spots.
Well, they eat bird eggs, turkey eggs.
Oh yeah, they eat everything.
Mice, they eat a lot. They hunt mice year round, of course.
I think they eat everything, including newborn calves.
If they get the chance or opportunity. Yeah. Thank you.
tell you, we're doing a quick frying of fish after we had this wonderful day on the lake, and it's a real simple way to do it, and you can't find better crappie or bluegill any other way. We take some Fry Magic and some of the spicier Andes breading. They're very kind of a cornmeal-based breading. We throw it in a bag. We put the fillets. Today we use beer because I didn't have any water up here at the Irish Acres, or milk at the Irish Acres kitchen. And what we've done is we just let it soak. We fill up the bag here. We shake it, shake and bake. We lay the fillets out on these plates. We let them sit for about a half an hour, and that breading gets coated into the beer. And then we're going to put them right in the grease. And you will not have any fresher fish that you could possibly have. I just can't believe how lucky we were today, Harry, to get ice cold fillets out of that cold water. Caught all those fish today, probably over 100 crappies. And now we're just going to do a quick cleaning and throw them in the fryer as soon as Pat gets done cleaning the bulk of the fish outside. That's it. Real simple. A little beer, some breading, dip it, lay it out on the platters, and then get your grease nice and hot and have a great dinner.
We just got done filleting all these fish. Now we're deboning them, taking the ribs out. He's going to bring me a bowl here pretty soon. But of course you got to keep your fingers out of the way. These are good old crappie bluegill fillets. Best eating you can get. And we're ready to rock and roll some of this stuff in. I bet you I cleaned about 60, 70 fish out here in the last half hour. So we're ready to go. Mike's getting the batter ready. What a perfect day. 75 degrees, first 75 degree day. They are small, but they're very tasty.
What are we going to cook them in?
We're cooking them in, what am I cooking them in? Canola oil.
No, what kind of unit you got there? That's pretty fancy.
This is a Waring, and it's a under $100 fryer. It's fantastic. It's got a big basket on it, and it heats your stuff up. We can cook for 8 or 10 people in here very, very easily. Otherwise, you're going to have to get one of those fancy ones like Pat's got with the double bays and the thing you have to hook on the back of a truck or something. But for, but for out here, this is a really nice unit because yeah. you can, when you're not using it anymore, you can just put the lid on it and go stick it inside on a shelf, and then when you need it, you bring it back out again.
Well, mine's propane too. You shouldn't do that in the garage.
But I've got 4 plates of fillets breaded in the other room, and we've got another 100 fillets here that Pat's cleaned. They'll have enough fish for to take home to the girls and have a nice meal tonight. The grease is hot. We put it at about 355, 360. And we're kind of working in tight quarters here. Pat's finishing up the other fillets while I went and breaded these. And as you can see that the grease is plenty hot. We're going to let these cook for about 3-4 minutes, and we'll start eating them here in about 15 minutes. Shake them up a little bit. That's it.
God, does that look good? Crispy? Oh, man.
They don't get better than this, you know.
Well, it was caught like 2 hours ago.
That was swimming a little bit ago.
Look at it. Look at the dogs.
Oh, man. Ready. Yeah, the dogs, they went in there.
Go ahead and have a piece of that fish.
Look at that. Oh. It don't get better than this. Take a couple hours off out of a day. Go out fishing or hunting with your buddies and then eating the fruits of your labor.
Sullivan and O'Brien fishing at Irish Acres the week of St. Paddy's Day.
And we get lucky and catch about 100 fish.
Yeah, we do. Good day.
Hey, we had a wonderful time fishing today. I got a hold of my buddy Mike here and said, hey, I got to get out and do some fishing. We need another segment for the TV show. And he says, I got just the thing to do. And we came out here to Irish Acres out by Victoria, Illinois, and we just caught a heck of a lot of fish. We would have had probably twice as many if he hadn't thrown them all overboard. But he's really good at that.
It's his lake.
Just didn't want Pat to have to clean too many.
But anyway, this is what life's all about. Getting out with your friends, having a good time, fishing and hunting. And a lot of us, we look for excuses not to get outdoors. But I'll tell you what, there was no excuse today, was there?
There was no excuse. And days like this, it's hard to keep us boys down, but our time is a little stretched thin anymore. So I think going out and getting a couple hours, it clears your mind, it recharges you, it just puts you in a great state, frame of mind.
Well, we all have stressful jobs. We're always working. We're doing all sorts of things. You're in the real estate business. You're in the restaurant business and carpet business and all sorts of things, real estate. And I'm in the radio, TV, magazine, farming, and everything else. So we all work hard. But it's times like this that make life worth living, wouldn't you say?
I would say so. Great, great job today, guys. And that, what a treat to have fresh fish right after you catch them.
Oh, man. No supper tonight. That was supper, buddy.
Oh, that definitely was. Now, when we get done filming this,
yeah,
I've got to go back in and bread enough fish for Patty to have for dinner tonight. That was what she said on the phone.
Yeah. She lets you go fishing.
Yeah, she did.
It'll be another, month, and we may have mushrooms.
Yep, I hope so.
They may be here early, folks, and we're going to make a nice show picking some mushrooms, some morels real soon. Hey, I want to thank you for watching another edition of Adventure Sports Outdoors. We'll see you next month.
Adventure Sports Outdoors, brought to you in part by Coresaw Lumber, manufacturers of quality hardwood products and buyers of standing timber in Smithfield.
Rawlings Trailer Sales, supplying sportsmen with all their trailer needs just south of Hopedale.
REMAX, specializing in commercial and recreational property in Peoria. Michael O'Brien, president.
Kaler's Irish Pub and Eatery, located on Peoria's riverfront, open 11 a.m. daily.
Alwyn & Sons Meat Company since 1957, located in Peoria Heights, Illinois.
Our thanks to these sponsors.